this afternoon will consist of two parts. The first part will be our graduation mass. Immediately following the mass, we will proceed with our 1993 graduation exercises. Graduation is a time of mixed feelings. I am sure that for the graduates, their parents, friends, and teachers, the day is marked with feelings of sadness, anxiety, joy, and hope. As we share these feelings, it is most appropriate that we pause and turn to God to give thanks and ask for guidance for what lies ahead. It is most fitting, therefore, that we gather together as a Christian community to participate in this celebration and recognize the achievements of our graduates. We will now have the procession of our graduates. I would ask you to please remain seated and withhold your applause until all the students have been seated.
to talk to us, and we're going to exchange gifts with him. So before we do any of that, let's just stop for a moment and ask ourselves, how does God find me this morning? If the answer is, well, I guess I've offended him since the last time I talked to him. Well, then maybe it's full thinking about what I can say to you today. And it repeats that word, happy, 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 happy. So I said, well, I'd like to be happy. I generally am most of the time. I wish I could be happy all the time. And then I asked myself the question, so what would make me happy? And I began to think of short-term things. I began to think of long-term things. I began to think of things that make me happy as a bishop, and what would make me happy as a person, and what would make me happy as a Christian. And of course, you can't talk about them all, so I picked out three. And I said, three things that would make me happy. To have more priests in my diocese. To lose about 40 pounds. And to see God. And I mean them all. And so I said, well, if I wanted to get more priests in the diocese, how would I get them? And I had
thank you.
behalf of the graduates, will be delivered this afternoon by Jolene Anderson. Jolene was selected by her fellow students to extend this greeting. Jolene.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to give this talk to you straight from my heart, but I'll probably rush and forget, so I'll just have to give my speech. I'd like to welcome you, parents, family, friends, teachers, and fellow students. Welcome to the graduation exercises of Edie Finn High School's class of 93. Class, I'd like to thank everyone for being here. To our parents goes a special thanks. Without you, there would be no us, and you were our first teachers. To our friends and family, thank you for coming today and showing your support as we have through the years whenever we needed you. To our teachers, I give all of you an A for helping us reach this milestone in our lives. Now to the graduating class. Welcome to today. This is our day. This afternoon, we'll be saying goodbye to many things, to friends and to teachers, and hello to new responsibilities and new opportunities. Today, many of us will be singled out for our strength, but all of us are being recognized for our accomplishments. And one more thanks is to God for being here with us today and every day. Thank you.
Frederick Amaya. Jolene Anderson, Principal's Honors. Jason Bershaw. Richard Vivan. Jocelyn Lai, Principal's Honors. Christy Buster. Carlos Bustos. Nancy Shandera, Principal's Honoris. Diane Charmaine Lado. Eliana Masika, on list. Mary June Lisboa, Principal's honor list. Kevin Lorenz. Nicole Lee. Amanda Lee. Jason Maher. Sydney Marcoux. Crystal McCurdy, Carol Orlenick. Ernesto Ortiz. Robert Palmer. Seraphon Fang. Darren Podluck.
Robert.
Jason Potapchuk. Jason Strager. Philip Strasky. Gregory Sutton. Curtis Torella. Brenda C. Stacy Vermet. Amos Way. Gregory Ward. Wayne Weisgerberg. Marco Zarabecki.
Together we experienced many formative events, which will always be remembered. For example,
earned our driver's license, spelling and out of love, and of course, spent a lot of time in school. We lived through glory and defeat with our sports teams. There are up and downs, mirroring the daily successes and frustrations we all went through. Just as our players could rely on their teammates and coaches, we could rely on our team now. Now we are confident seniors. Together we proudly represent our school while setting an example for the younger students. We should take pride in the fact that being sets an example to the world as a place where a diverse population interacts with drivers. We are proud that they equipped us with the tools needed to survive whatever the future has to offer. Thank the school administrators, Mr. Farwell, Mr. Hardy, and Mr. Moore, along with counselors for running the school smoothly, for their dedication to meeting the needs of the students. The Christian Ethics team, the Christian Ethics Department, along with their chaplain, Father Matt.
Thank you, Jeff. You've spoken well. Your message of gratitude for the past and hope for the future, I'm sure, expresses the feelings in the hearts of each of your fellow graduates. I would like to take this opportunity to call upon Mr. Modest Kowal, Chairman of the Saskatoon Catholic Board of Education, to present Jeff with the valedictorian plaque. Mr. Kowal.
Yeah.